A couple of months ago, I made myself a quick leather wallet. It turned out pretty nice, so I thought I'd make another one, but this time I'll show you how I made it. This is 5-ounce Kodiak leather that has been oil tanned. It is a very nice leather with a sort of waxy feel to it. The design for this wallet is extremely simple, consisting of four basic pieces. The more complex the wallet is, the thinner the leather would need to be, and I wanted this one to last. Once again, this is a very simple wallet and could be easily adapted to make a duct tape wallet, for example. The nice thing about the leather is that it'll just get better with age. This is barge glue. It is a very strong contact cement, like you might use for shoes. After about 5 minutes, the contact cement was tacky enough to assemble. After the glue has set up, you no longer need to worry about having the pieces move while you punch the holes for the stitches. These are 2 millimeter stitches and are spaced 1/4 inch from the edge. For a saddle stitch, or a double stitch, the threads need to be about 3 times the length of the stitch. Be generous though, because it sucks to run out of thread with only 1 inch to go. Thank you. Here you can see how close I came to running out of thread. This is a number 2 edge beveler, and will round all of the edges of the leather. Sort of like a roundover bit for a hand router. I then sanded with 80 grit to even up all the edges before burnishing. This stuff has the consistency of snot, and after using the burnisher, gives a nice smooth surface to the edge. The effect is that it makes the two pieces of leather look like a single piece folded over. I think this new wallet turned out nicer than my first one.